I'm standing in front of where I was born. No, not physically, but spiritually. Back in 1996, I was discipled and mentored in this building behind me. This building is our chapel, or used to be our chapel. Now, there are alumni that have come through this program that have fond memories of this place. Well, back in 96, I remember sitting around in a circle with 10 men because that's all the students we had back then, 10 students. Kind of crazy to think that now we have 154 students between the prison and our ministry here on campus. Well, I can remember sitting around in that circle with those 10 men and two of my spiritual fathers in the faith, Bill Everett, the founder of this ministry, and Orlando Rivera. And it was in those moments that I was formed. It was in those moments that I was challenged. And so I'm standing here because I want to remember our roots today. Remembering those who have come before us. Now, Bill and Orlando and so many have come before to make this happen and to be where we're at today. For the campus to be where it's at today is not just because of the current staff that we have or me serving as director. The reality is we stand on the shoulders of giants. And without these men, none of this would be possible. I'm reminded of that this week because during this pandemic, I've received numerous calls from pastors all over Oklahoma. Pastors who have supported this ministry from day one, just calling to check up on us and see how we're doing. Churches like Warrica First Assembly, one of our graduates went to pastor that church, Johnny Flores, Pastor Barnes from Lawton First Assembly, and Pastor Brooks from Christ Legacy, and Apache Pentecostal First, and Elgin First with Larry Toma. And I could go on and on talking about those individuals who have sent us checks and called us. Tonkawa First Assembly is another one. The Bridge in Mustang calling to check and to send us an offering. And so, man, I'm just reminded that we don't stand alone here. It's because of churches all over Oklahoma. It's because of people who have come and sacrificed. Now, there are also those people who are in the shadows, those people who never wanted recognition and have never come forward for that. People like AG Maps workers who have come and parked their RV here to work on buildings like the one behind me, to set this little chapel on the ground and to remodel it time and time again. There are so many people that have labored long in making this place what it is. And if it was not for those who have gone before us, we wouldn't be standing here right now. My life would not be transformed. The thousands of men who have come and gone from this campus and their lives have been transformed, it wouldn't have happened. But because of the obedience of God's people and God flowing through them as they make themselves available, lives have been transformed. There's a scripture in Romans chapter 11, verse 18, and it says this: "Do not boast against the branches, but if you do boast, remember that you do not support the root, but the root supports you." Now, in this passage of scripture, Paul is talking to Gentile converts who are obviously boasting against the Jewish people. He's rebuking these Gentile converts, and he is drawing this beautiful picture of a branch that's just now been grafted into a tree. Its union is still healing, and this little branch has got little tender green leaves on it, and it's just begun to grow. And it's looking back at the tree and the elaborate root structure that supports it, and it's boasting. Not admiring those who have gone before him, but rather boasting against the branches. Now, what a beautiful picture today as we think of those who have gone before us and laid the roots that have allowed us to grow and become the men of God that we are, that have allowed us to receive a discipleship and recovery in a place like this. Now, the Apostle Paul is talking to these Gentile converts and he's rebuking them. Do not boast against the branches, but if you do boast, remember this, that while you're boasting against the very thing that's giving you life. The Jewish people, the leadership of people like Abraham and Moses and Jacob and Isaac, those who have laid this elaborate root system that allows you to even grow. And so I just want to pause for a moment. All those pastors and churches that I that I mentioned earlier that have given and called, all those churches out there like Skeedy First Assembly and Hammond First and Thomas First Assembly, churches all over this state that constantly support us. If it was not for you, we wouldn't be here. If it wasn't for this elaborate root structure of men of God, of widows who send in $30 a month, of all of those who have come together to form this elaborate root structure that gives us life, that gives us sustenance, we look back at the roots today and we thank you.